Okay, so we're looking at the rectifier with smoothing, and we're trying to come up with a simple way of estimating the amount of droop or ripple that occurs in each cycle of the input voltage. Okay, so if this is the period here, we want to see a very small decay for this amount right here. And remember, this goes as e to the minus t over tau. All right, so that means that t over, from here, we're looking over the time period given by t. So e to the minus t over rc is going to be what we want to take a look at. And that's approximately equal to 1 minus t over rc for the case where this is small. You can look up approximations for the exponential to see that this is indeed the case. Or you can just plug some numbers in and see that it's true as long as t over rc is small. All right, so we have v c is vc naught e to the minus t over rc, which is approximately equal vc naught times 1 minus t over rc. Okay, since this is the initial value, this term must give us the approximation. Remember, we're taking it for the case where t is equal to t, so let's write this as vc naught 1 minus t over rc. So the actual droop or ripple is approximately equal to vc naught t over rc. For the cases that we've looked at, this is probably going to give us a little bit of an overestimate. It's going to give us an overestimate because we really are not looking at a decay all the way from that time to that time, but rather we're looking at a decay from that time to that time. But as long as t is much greater than rc, which it is for the problems we're looking at, we get a reasonable approximation, at least enough to be able to get a good ballpark number for the amount of droop that we see between here and here. All right, so if we take a case where you have an input voltage of, say, 12 volts for a half-wave rectifier, and it requires 0.6 volts to turn it on, then the peak voltage is going to be about 12 minus 0.6, or about 11.4 volts, which would be the voltage right about there. Okay, so then the ripple is going to be about 11.4 times t divided by rc for a 60 hertz sine wave. T is equal to 16.7 milliseconds. And if we choose R to be something like 100 and C to be 500 microfarads, then we can plug in the numbers and see the droop is going to be somewhere around 2 volts. And if you look at the solution to the first problem on quiz 4 from the spring of 2009, you can see this is exactly the problem that we're taking a look at. And we'll be able to see that this droop estimate gives a pretty good idea of how to come up with a sketch. So once you figure out how much this droop is, you just draw a straight line between there and there. And we have a very reasonable sketch for what the value of for what the output voltage should be. So here is the calculation. And if you compare that to the answer on page 5 of the solution, you see that's exactly what the droop ends up being.